Welcome back, everybody. So I want to continue our whole discussion on everything that we are feeling as cancer patients and how lockdown has brought some of those feelings back. And I think the one thing is that when I was diagnosed with cancer, we were grieving for a lost sense of normality. I think my normal was that I didn't have cancer. And now that I do have cancer, the normal that I used to know was gone. Because I think what came with cancer was all the doctor's appointments, the chemotherapy, the radiation, the blood tests, the scans, which is now part of my life. So every now and again, I need to go for blood tests. I still need to go for scans. I still need to go for post-chemo injections. So my normal that I knew prior to my diagnosis was pretty much a healthy person who never ever used to go to the doctor. Now suddenly I've got an ICD-10 code. I've been registered for chronic medicine. Sad, sad, sad. But anyway, so yeah, I am grieving the normal. I am grieving the feeling of feeling healthy. But that often obviously went through the window. And I think what happens now during lockdown, it's again that whole thing from the normality of being free to do whatever you want. That's gone out the window. So we all have to now face staying at home, not having freedom to go wherever we want, seeing whoever we want, spending time with the loved people that we love. So it has changed, and one wants to feel sad because normal makes us stick. Normal makes us who we are. Normal allows us to live out our personalities, to be ourselves. And now suddenly we are restricted to staying at home. For some people, I suppose this is normal. So normality is not so bad. But yeah, I think for me, who I'm a Pilates teacher, I also see a lot of people on a daily basis being so isolated. Yeah, it makes me sad because I feel alone. And I think being and feeling alone can make us feel a little bit sad. Then the other one that I also think is important that I've noticed is that we are now confronted being alone with ourselves, you know. A lot of people get their energy from other people, and a lot of people, I suppose, who are going through tough times, enjoy spending time with other people so that they don't have to confront their inner self. But I think during my diagnosis process, I was alone a lot, and I had a lot of time to reflect. I had a lot of time to think about my life, where I'm going, what's going to happen in the future, and what is going to be the meaning of my life forward. And I think during this lockdown time, we also have a lot of free time, a lot of time where we don't have to engage with people, a lot of empty time, empty spaces, time that doesn't have value, time that doesn't bring up anything specific. So I think a lot of people enjoy being with others, and then when they're on their own, they just don't cope. But yeah, I think it's very similar for me. They're the same feelings of, so I do enjoy spending time with myself, but when I choose to, I think when we land up being forced to spend time with yourself, it becomes harder. You just don't want to do it. Now I want to see friends. Now I want to spend time with people. So definitely a challenge being alone by yourself, especially for me, since I am don't have kids and my husband works every day. Yeah. The other one that I also find relevant is when I was diagnosed with cancer, you don't know how long you're going to live. You don't know what your diagnosis or your prognosis is going to be. Jy weet nie, gaan ek het maak vir hierdie jaar, gaan ek Kersfees sien, gaan ek nie. En ek dink wat ek dan optel is, of het opgetel het, is dat ek gaan net lewe vir dag tot dag. So ek gaan net doen wat ek kan vir vandag. Ek gaan nie nou ewe skielik wil beplan vir die future nie. Ek gaan nie worry oor die verlede nie. Ek gaan net vir vandag my beste gee, tyd met mense spandeer wat ek lief vir is. My energy kanaliseer basies in die toe vandag. En I think now with the coronavirus and the lockdown, we are forced to live day by day. We don't know. We don't know how long it's going to last. We don't know what's going to change. So living day by day just makes it easier. Enjoy today. Do what's fun for today. Don't wait for tomorrow and yesterday's gone, so there's nothing you can do about it. So, yeah, to be forced to do just for today, because I think a lot of people live in the future. One day when I am, one day when we go overseas, let's plan overseas, let's plan next weekend, let's plan to go with, out with friends. For now, it's just today and hope for tomorrow to be different, but not. And then I also think holding on to hope, it's like a lifeline. I think when you're diagnosed with cancer, you live with hope. You live, hope is your fuel. You hope that you will get better. You hope that you won't feel so sick. You hope that your results will be better than what it was when you went the first time. You hope the cancer will go away. You hope, yeah, that you might live a long time still. And now, we're also just living with hope. We hope we can get out of this lockdown. We hope things will change. Things will never be back to normal. But we hope that there will be grace, that we can get out, that we can do things that we used to do. So, hope is big. I think hope is being sure of what you can't see, but certain of what you can believe. So, yeah, so those are a few things that I, as a cancer patient, have picked up. Very similar. Living in the moment, living for today. Normal will never be the same. Just grieving what you had. And yeah, let's just make the best of every single day. Remember, memento vivere is my motto, and I've got this on a pendant around my neck, which is to live for today. Make the most of today. Because we don't know if tomorrow's going to be there.